Welcome to this special program, Tete-a-Tete. I'm Sudhanshu Ranjan, and our guest this week is Dr.Bindeshwar Pathak, who has become a byword for cleanliness and sanitation. In fact, for the last 3-4 decades, he has been working for the liberation of the people who are at the rock bottom of the institutionalized caste system and face maximum discrimination. Obviously, these people are scavengers, and he has brought about colossal change in their lives. They have been liberated, they have been trained, and they have really been elevated in the society. So, Dr. Pathak, welcome to our program. We have just finished observing the 60th centennial of Mahatma Gandhi, 150 years. And his main focus was on cleanliness, which he said that cleanliness is the second name of God. And he not only said so, he in fact practiced himself. And for the first time, when in the Calcutta Congress, most probably in 1901, when he was told that scavengers will come and clean the toilet and other things, he took it upon himself and did everything, took bucket, water, broom, and did this. So when the father of the nation makes it a mission, we think it was the biggest scourge of our society that a particular class had been doing this work, and now you have taken up, and obviously you have been able to liberate them and to free the country from open defecation. The Prime Minister is also focusing too much on it. So first, an introductory remark from you: how did all this begin, and then we shall take the conversation forward.
Actually, if you see the human scavenging, this practice started, there are different opinions, but I think in the Vedic period. And there, a particular class was assigned this job to clean human feces from the household and to throw at a distance outside. And this practice started continuing. Then if you come to Puran period, Buddha period, in Buddha period, Lord Buddha was passing from Vaishali, and one person was carrying human feces on his shoulder in a bucket. So he asked from Anand, who is this person? He has hidden himself from me. People come and salute me, touch their feet. And who is this person who has got hidden from me? And he replied, Lord, he was a scavenger, human scavenger, called Polkas. The Pali word was there, Polkas. So he has got...
He did not want himself to be close to club
with you. So then Lord Buddha said, no, ask him to come. And so he came and touched his feet, and then Buddha
touched his feet?
No, he asked that, Buddha.
Scavenger.
Lord Buddha asked that scavenger to touch his feet, and then he went ahead. So, if you see, that system continued Buddha period, Gupta period, Mughal period, British period. So, this practice has been continuing since centuries.
There are stories about Lord Buddha that he went to the house of Dalit, untouchable, and took water from them. And there are so many stories when he really wanted to unshackle the society from the barriers of caste.
So that is how this all started. There was a committee formed in 1957 of a member parliament. Report came in 1960, Malkani committee. And that committee suggested how to improve the living conditions of the human scavengers, and how they should be given the spectacle, the container to clean human, carry human skita, or alternately to give in this trolley, the gumboots, then the houses to live in, children should go to schools. So all the welfare measures were suggested in that report, but there was no end of scavenging.
Meant of?
End of scavenging, human scavenging. So there was no any alternative.
So did the government take any action on the basis of that report?
Yes, the government took the report action, but only welfare measures, not to end the
practice. Not to liberate them from scavenging.
Yes, because there was no alternative.
Yes.
So when the centenary year, to celebrate the birth century of Mahatma Gandhi, then the government of India took up this cause and asked the state government to get dry toilets, bucket toilets, cleaned by human scavengers to flush one. So this is a flush toilet, not any dry toilet, bucket toilet. So the centenary committees set up in different states, they started and they took up the cause. As a child, 7-8 years old, a lady called Doom, she used to come to my house to deliver the utensils made of bamboos, like soup, dagra.
During that only these people make soup and dagra.
Yes, dagra. So, when she used to return, my grandmother used to sprinkle water to the land belong to us. So I was surprised as a child, I was curious to know what happens. Many people come to my house, grandma does not do like this, but what particular lady? People say she was untouchable, and when she walks on the land, it becomes polluted. Just to purify, she sprinkles water. So I have to touch her and just see whether I change the body and the color, something like that. Nothing used to happen. One day she saw me touching, and that became a problem. So she started crying and then shouting, and asked people to come. Children were playing nearby, asked, caught hold of me, and put cow dung inside her mouth, and put cow urine and a lot of Ganges water to purify me, the harsh winter of January. So that I had no idea about all these things because I was a child. But I was curious, but I did not know this was the system in the country. So I wanted to be a teacher in the University of Patna. This was your sole aim. But by chance, I joined a society, Bihar Gandhi Centenary Celebration Committee. That committee was formed to celebrate the birth century of Mahatma Gandhi. And that committee had taken up many causes. One was to restore the human rights and dignity of human scavengers and untouchables, and to bring them on a par with others in the mainstream of the society. So General Secretary asked me to do it. I told him the story of my childhood. But he did not agree. He said, no, I don't know your Brahmin or what caste you belong, but I see light in you, you can do this. So I went and lived in the colony of untouchables in Betia. It is coincidence that Mahatma also started his freedom movement from Champaran.
And Pitiharava Ashram is so well known.
So that way, I went and lived in the colony of untouchables, the human scavengers, in Betia town for 3 months. I lived with them, had food with them, talked with them, came to know the origin of the untouchables and the way they used to live and what other things. I suggested many things to them. One thing happened, it was very cruel, that a boy being hurt, he was attacked by the bull. People rushed to save him. But somebody shouted from the
crowd
that he belonged to untouchables colony. Everybody left him. People were surprised. So I was with 2-3 persons from the colony, going to have a cup of tea in the town. So we took him to hospital and the boy died. So there I decided to fulfill the dreams of Mahatma Gandhi. So my journey begins from there.
So when you went to live with those untouchables in their colony, again there must have been protest from the family?
Yes, my father was sad, my mother also not very happy. The society also didn't allow me to sit with them. The most opposition came from my father-in-law. He was a doctor, a rich person, so he used to become very angry. One day he became so angry, he said, I don't want to see your face. Had not we been Brahmins, I would have married my daughter to somebody else. What do you do? People ask me, what son-in-law is doing? What should I tell them? In Bihar, there is no practice to reply the elders. But that day, in a very low voice, I replied that, look, I have taken the challenge to fulfill the dreams of Mahatma Gandhi. I have to turn the pages of history of India. So now I cannot leave this job. If you can help your daughter till I am successful, it will be good. If you want to marry her to somebody else, I will have no objection. So just see how it was so vehemently opposing this idea, living with untouchables and working for them. So the resistance came from society.
That resistance is always there. When Gandhi just started his own movement to liberate the untouchables, bring them on par with the other castes, then there was attack on him in Pune, especially after the communal award. He fasted against communal award that was revoked, and then he started his movement Achyut Todhar. There was a bomb attack on him, bomb was hurled at him, bomb exploded. Luckily he was saved. In Devghar, Gandhi was attacked. It was a murderous attack, but all the blows he could not personally receive because he was sitting inside the jeep and the hood received all those blows of lathi. So Gandhiji also had to face very tough resistance.
Of course.
I don't know how much difference could you find after 3-4 decades when you started, because you started in 1970.
Yes.
Gandhiji did in 1930s. He also started Harijan only to propagate those ideas. Harijan in English and Harijan Sevak, Harijan Bandhu in Indian languages. So how much difference did you feel that in those 40 years had come, the society had really got prepared to accept those changes?
Actually, if you see that system of open defecation and manual scavenging used to continue, but social workers, followers of Gandhi, social organizations, then non-governmental organizations, government organizations like Indian Council of Medical Research, All India Institute of Hygiene and Public Health in Calcutta, Environmental Centers of Project in Delhi and Trivandrum, Lucknow, all they started the research, R&D on this. But nobody could find the proper solution to the problem. A committee was formed in 1957 of members of parliament.
That you told, Malkani Committee.
Malkani Committee.
Yes, yes.
To form, and there they gave suggestions for the welfare of the people, of the human scavengers, a good container so that nothing.
Welfare measures were there, but not the liberation of scavengers.
So not the liberation.
Dirty work.
So for the first time, in 1967, the government of India decided to celebrate the birth century of Mahatma Gandhi.
Yeah. We shall come back to all these things first. Let's have a break for it will be a very short break. Please stay with us, and when I come back, then we shall be talking about the low technology that Dr. Pathak had invented, and that in fact went a long way to liberate these scavengers, and also his contributions to environment. Welcome back. We are talking to Dr. Bindeshwar Pathak. Pathak ji, you could bring about a major change in the society because you invented a low-cost technology, two-pit flush septic latrine. So I would like to know more about the technology. How could you think of it, and what is actually this technology all about?
Actually, the technology is that in human excreta, there are bacteria, and those bacteria convert human excreta into fertilizer, into soil. So what do you do? And then you cover it. So the very simple technology, you have to rediscover. And there are two pits. One is at a time, other is kept standby. The first one is full, switch over to another one. And the first one after 2 years becomes fertilizer manure. It contains phosphorus, nitrogen, potassium. It's a good fertilizer. So this is a simple technology. And because of this technology, you can end the practice of open defecation or human scavenging. But not you can end. Now it has ended.
But I have read that when you introduced this technology, you were derided and ridiculed that it's
of
not
course,
possible.
It happens all with all immunizations. Anything you invent, anything you do, new thing, people laugh, make jokes, but then they accept it. So now they...
First they laugh, then they oppose, and then they accept.
They accept. So this happened with me also. But the most important thing is that Honorable Prime Minister of India, Shri Narendra Modi ji, took up this cause, and finally, now India is free from open defecation.
In fact, cleanliness has become a movement, a people's movement.
Yes.
And obviously, to a great extent, it is a success.
Yes.
Though some more work is to be done, definitely, but now we can proudly say that it is now free from open defecation.
Yes. Everyone is trying now to keep it clean, make it clean. India is looking better than earlier.
It was ridiculed that India is a vast and open toilet everywhere. People are seen urinating and using themselves.
Yeah.
And V.S. Naipaul mentioned in his book, An Area of Darkness, that anywhere by the side of road or railways, you find them defecating in the open.
Therefore, so the credit goes to Prime Minister of India, and that he took the initiative. Attempts were made earlier also. But the way he did, nobody did earlier. Dr. Raghuvansh Prasad Singh, Dr. Raghuvansh Prasad, Jairam Ramesh, or the minister, they also tried their own way. But when Modi ji took up this cause, now you see difference in the cleanliness of the country. So then the human scavengers, I had to first give them relief from this occupation, because the million dollar question was what to do.
So liberation, then
rehabilitation.
Then vocational training, and then education for the next generation, and then finally their social elevation. In five stages you wanted to liberate.
Yes. That was very important. So first I gave them education to read and write. I started sending them to banks. Then asked people like I.K. Gujral, Manika Gandhi, Manishika Iyer, that they should adopt their own family. Just to have.
You had done a program in Patna which I had attended.
Patna also, yes. Patna also I did. Mm-hmm. And then, then what happened? I give them vocational training to earn their livelihood, making papadam, noodles, pickles, carpet making, this bridal makeup. All these things we taught them. Now they are earning. When they used to clean the toilets, they used to earn 300 rupees. Now they earn 15,000 rupees per month. 20,000 rupees per month. So they have economically, they also are now very good there. And I took them to temples, like Nathadwar temple, Alwar temple, and asked the upper caste people, Brahmins, to sit with them, to have food with them, allowed them to participate in the puja and other things. So by doing all these things, now...
So it is social elevation as well as poverty elevation,
yes.
Both. So economically as well as socially, they are being lifted.
Yes. So Ambedkar, he gave four indicators to know whether untouchability has gone or not. He said, first, when everybody will go to temple to worship deities. Secondly, that everybody will take bath in the same pond. Then can draw water from the same waste to drink, and they have a common dining. And Ambedkar said, unless society accepts them, this is very important.
Actually, the problem is that Sanskritization did not happen. Upward mobility of the lower class.
Yes.
And Ambedkar, as you have referred to him, he compared the caste structure to a multi-storied building without a staircase.
Yeah.
Because one who is at the ground floor, he cannot go up. and the person is staying at the first floor, he or she cannot go up. So it is without any staircase. That is the caste structure in India.
Yes. So therefore, now, earlier they used to go to clean toilets from the back door. They're not allowed to come from the front in the house. Now, they go to same house, not other house, same house to sell papadam, to pickles, and do facial of women. And when they go, women ask them, oh, prepare tea, go to kitchen, prepare tea for me also, you also have drink, you take tea, and then do facial. Just see the change.
It is a major change.
Major change, that you cannot touch a person. Now you are asking her to prepare tea for you. Now they are being invited in the function.
So there is a change in the mindset.
They change
the
mindset.
You cannot say that nothing is changing.
Yes.
There is a change.
So that is most important. And the most important is that I did all things with peace and non-violence, what Gandhi wanted. Che Guevara, who took a liberation of Cuba, he came to Delhi in 1959, and he said, to feed hungry people, we can force.
All these leaders of the new left, Che Guevara, French Fanon, they supported violence.
Yes, no.
They openly supported violence.
Violence. Hmm. But same person, in the same meeting, what I was telling you, same person, same Che Guevara, same person, same, in the same meeting. He said, no, I do not endorse my views of violence. Because if they chase the persons who obstruct them, then they will retaliate. So he suggested that you should take up help of non-violence and peace of Gandhi. So he was of the opinion that now we should not take violence in our hands to change
Patanji,
society.
In India, I think the main problem is that we have a feudal mindset. People who have got a status, they will do white collar jobs. People without a status will do menial jobs. And who are at the top, they will don't work, they will do nothing. And that's why Gandhi talked of bread labor. Unless you work hard, you don't have any right to have bread. So, unless you give dignity to labor, the society cannot change. And I think through this, we are also recognizing the dignity of labor.
Yes, this is most important. Because, as you rightly said, if you big man means you don't work. That this is the definition of the big man. You don't laugh, you don't sing, you don't. All these things, you see what are the Western countries. Yeah, but in India, I entirely agree with you that lesser you work, you are a bigger person, society is accepted. But now, the dignity of labor is coming. Now people are accepting them. And therefore, what is important, the way I have changed the society, the acceptance. I was forgetting the actual word at the time. If the oppressed change the oppressor, oppressor will change the oppressed. And this will continue. And therefore, Che Guevara said that better we should adopt non-violence and peace of Mahatma Gandhi to change the society. So what you find is all through the movement that I have not taken anything of violence, all non-violence.
Yes, you have never resorted to violence, never advocated violence.
Yes, no any same agitation, nothing against anybody. Just gradually, peacefully, we have brought the change. And the most important thing is that they sit together, they dine together, they accept a gift.
Commensalism, dining together, sitting together,
yeah.
Talking together. Pathakji, one last question. Yes. I've heard that so many times your name was considered for Nobel Prize. So I'd like to know from you what happened.
Yes, this is correct. Many times I got a letter also. From Nobel Committee or selection, 2-3-4 times. But you know, There is one novel, one novel, novel for the whole entire world, and only one in one year.
Yes.
So everybody cannot get it. Even Mahatma Gandhi couldn't get it.
No, that was because of some politics.
Maybe because of this happened. So the question is that my name was selected many times, but finally I did not get it.
But any work is more important than awards.
Of course, what I feel, suppose what people say about you. Now you said that why I am not got Nobel. That this feeling of the people, that is award. So this is very important, that whatever I have done for the society, you go, not my work is so vast, we cannot repeat now, but just say one by one you can take. So far sanitation and untouchability is concerned. Now just see, had not I invented two-pit technology?
Yes.
Sudhanshu Charaya. I gave the system of maintenance of public toilets for sludge. In 1974, I built first toilet in Patna to maintain public toilets on a periodic basis. Now see everywhere. I have invented technology of how you can get biogas from human skitter. I can use for burning lamp, cooking food, you can contribute energy, street light, and then the water is treated. In Patna, I gave light from 1983 to 1990 from Bailey Road to Botanical Gardens, Gandhi Udyan Park. And there, once Ken Sahai, once the mayor of Patna, he asked me that to connect my house with your electricity. He was, his mother objected. No, this
is
from
human skitter.
Yes. I will have to wash my hands every time when it puts on and puts off. But after 1.5 months, he said, no, I will wash my hand. Asked Mr. Pathak to give the light because the free pick a background. Background of the electricity. So question is that if you see humble sanitation and untouchability, both dearest subject of Mahatma Gandhi. And rightly I can say that after Mahatma Gandhi, Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Modi, has done right work to make India clean, to keep India clean.
Successfully made a people's
yes,
movement.
Yes, people's
Patanji,
movement.
We shall have to cut it short because of the shortage of time. So thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mr. Ayam.
Yes, yes, you let our viewers know in details about all this movement, sanitation, cleanliness. So thank you, really.
Thank you indeed.
And it is really very unfortunate and nothing short of an irony that people who clean everything, who make our lives comfortable because they are menial jobs, they don't get respectability, and people who do nothing, they get respectability. But now there is a colossal change in the mindset, people's thinking is changing, and that's something very heartening, and we're very sure that everything will change in a few years from now if there is something left. Thank you so much for watching this interview, Dr. Bindeshwar Pathak.